Thank you. What shall I do today? Who am I?
Please, listen to me for just a moment. It's very important.
Maybe next time. Everybody wants...
Gone out of there in one piece. I understand that Omalexia can be a little rough on her toys. While you were getting cozy with the goddess, I discovered something interesting. The house Dresvom outside the city is on high alert. I saw the guards get violent with people for just walking by. They're using a courier named Thoraville to deliver bribes to house leaders and city officials. I think they're hiding something. You know me so well, but we'll need to get the courier's key. He's been picking up wine here, then delivering bottles around town. Tends to keep a bottle or two as he goes along. We might be able to use that to our advantage. Poison. Don't give me that look. It's not lethal poison. It'll just put him in a nice deep sleep. Follow him, and when he takes a sip from his bottle and falls over, you can grab his key. Don't get too cocky, Hero. House Dres is full and far, and its agents are on edge. If the courier thinks he's being followed, he might get spooked. You want him relaxed enough to start drinking, got it? So keep your distance. How's the wine downstairs? Did you find the special blend? Good. Now we wait for the courier to come pick it up. We don't want to draw any attention to ourselves. Stay close. There he is now. Closer. Come closer. No, eyes front. Look at me. We're close friends. Closer. I said something funny. You're laughing. He just passed by. He's got the wine. Like what you see, Hera? Of course you do. He's almost at the door. Keep watching me. All right, he's out. Go!
That was practically gay.
Who's there? Is someone following me?
I don't know, all of a sudden.
The Registrar still won't see us, and our guar steaks are beginning to spoil in their
carts. Damn these crowds! We're going to lose our entire shipment.
You see, I'm busy.
Even if you hadn't destroyed those shipments, I'm
Welcome, friend.
I'm in the middle of something. I made it. Did you miss me? Find anything exciting before I got here? Well, well, well. See that? That's an impressive trapdoor for a simple farmhouse cellar. I love it when my hunches pan out. Isn't it obvious? Open the door. They must be hiding something good down there. Let's go see. I'm surprised House Trails managed to do anything with the Ordinators on high alert. Not much gets past them, even when they're not looking for trouble. Over here, hero. I'm surprised House Trails managed to do anything. Part of me hope what I want and what I do are usually very different things, my friend. Let's just get down there and see what's going on. With any luck, we'll be done before the Corner Club serves tonight's Flaming Nick stew. And the drinks will be on me.
Woohoo, sewers.
About time you got here. What took you so long? Come on,
hey.
Let's see what's down here.
Funny, sewers.
No, this can't be right. This isn't good. I wish my partner Varon was here. He'd know what to do. Wait, I don't.
Varon
would bring my neck for being down here. So, fair warning. This could be bad. Real bad.
Hmm?
This cave system, it links directly to the sewers beneath Mournhold. Well, to part of them. The sewers are more extensive than you'd think. That's why I couldn't find the Morborn. They can move through these tunnels without being noticed. Let's just say I've spent more than my share of time sneaking around beneath cities. If you've seen one sewer, you've seen them all. Protections were placed down here to hide people. People with blood on their hands. People like me. If they found a way to activate the Daedric wards again, then the Morborn have a virtual hidden highway to use against us. That's not relevant right now, hero. Stay focused. Find the Morborn and figure out what they're up to. And we can talk about my sordid yet extremely intriguing past. Aelitz? Really? Search around. There should be a door somewhere nearby. I'll keep an eye out. Let me guess. The door won't open? There's got to be something controlling it. Look around a bit, and watch out for those creatures. Ugly.
Thought I was stuck for real. Uh-oh. But I did. Turn this one, and then I turn the other one. One more switch.
I knew you could do it. Meet me inside.
My city, my people shall not be harmed.
Lords, they're active. That's impossible. No one outside my organization should have been able to activate them. If the Morborn are using this base, the entire city is in danger. No, they can't be. Maybe a splinter group or something? I don't know what to think. Not all of us exactly see eye to eye on our current situation, but to join up with a Morborn? That's just idiotic. I suppose anyone with knowledge of the Daedric arts might be able to activate them. I'm not an expert on magic, you know. I need to warn somebody. Veron needs to know about this. The wards use Daedric magic to protect these tunnels from scrying magic. Even works against the Tribunal, from what I've been told. Anyone down here is practically invisible to the city above. Do what you do best. Rush in, swinging weapons and tossing magic around like there's no tomorrow. If you find whoever activated the wards, get them to tell you what's going on down here. I know you will. That's why I ran into you on your way to the temple. I'll drop the ordinators an anonymous tip. Maybe even get word to your beloved goddess. Hopefully someone will show up to give you a hand. Just don't die on me, hero. Got that? It used to be, but we haven't used these halls in a long, long time. Not since we fell out of favor. That's just it. There shouldn't be anything down here. Not anymore. Sure, in the past, when the wards were active, we used this place to come and go as we pleased. There wasn't a better hiding place for a group of dedicated assassins for hire.
Yeah.
Yay, werewolf increased to level 8. My inventory is full, yay. Back this way. Oh my lord. Okay, what if I...
Stay back! Attacking the city! Stay back!
What fool dares enter the lair of the Malmor? Wait, we know you. Would be pleased with us when we display your head on a pike.
Daedric magic permeates the air. Those who practice forbidden magic shall pay dearly for their crimes. It seems I am in your debt again, champion. Your friend. She thinks to hide from me. But I heard her words of warning. She cares for you. But Verona is wounded. I shall take her to the Mage's Guild where she can receive care. Find her there.
Must I suffer so?
I know you.
You were in the sewers, right? You saved me, didn't you? I don't remember much, but I remember you. I came to Mournhold a few weeks ago, to visit some friends. I guess word got out that a Talvani was in the city, because I suddenly found myself tied up in the sewers. The Morborn. They kept badgering me about Daedric magic. Are you really so naive? House Talvani rejected membership in the Ebonheart Pact. We remain isolated, pursuing our own interests along the Talvani coast. That's just one of the reasons the other houses distrust us. Members of House Talvani are known for their knowledge of all types of magic. I guess they assumed I could make the old wards active again. I did what they wanted. Eventually, it was either that or... I don't want to think about it. I don't care what you believe, but I never heard of the Morborn before I came to this vile city. And I certainly had no intention of betraying the Tribunal before they threatened me. I only know what I heard. I think they were planning an attack of some sort. They sent off a large group just before you showed up. I told all of this to the Sacred Lady. She said you would visit me and I should tell you to find an ordinator.
This questline is very long.
The Sacred Lady told me to tell you to talk to...
Just in time. The Sacred Lady asked us to watch for you.
Indeed. The Sacred Lady wants you to know that she wasn't able to eliminate all of the pests you found in the sewers.
So Amalexia believes. I was told to convey upon you the gratitude of the Tribunal, and to inform you that the Sacred Lady still has need of your services. And one more thing. The Sacred Lady wishes to speak with you, personally. She awaits your presence. Please, head to the temple at once.
Yay, level 21.
The Sacred Lady doesn't share all of her secrets with those who serve her, but as far as I know, no attack has yet occurred within the confines of the city. We've been ordered not to discuss the entirety of the situation in public, to prevent panic, you understand. The Lady summons you. Go.
I saw some. Or I'm gonna be bad pit.
Don't leave town without the problem.
Did you finish it? Yeah? Give me a few minutes, I'll take a break and then I'll come see you, okay?
Thank you.
this orc. Still too much, for me.
Yeah.
Don't leave town without the proper equipment.
Doodly, doodly, doodly do. Gotta go to the bank and put stuff away. Where's the bank? I don't know.
Good stuff here.
There's a bank right here. Find it. Inside the thing.
If you're looking for the Bank of Morn.
Have to use that. What am I supposed to do with these? Okay. Can I put those in?
If you're looking for the bank,
Oh, I guess they go. Listen, I gotta find them.
Some of my own children have betrayed me. I am rarely an angry god, but this time there shall be a reckoning. Rage consumes me. The Morborn invade my home, they attack my children, they attack me. You have proven yourself loyal and capable. I call upon you to serve me once more. The Morborn penetrated the temple and opened a portal into oblivion. Even now, Daedra swarm within its hallowed halls. Such sacrilege must not stand. Banish the Daedra that defile our temple. Defeat them, and then make your way to my altar. While you slay their minions, I shall determine what the Morborn are really up to. Now go, and carry my divine rage with you. You shall hear, though you shall never speak of it. This enemy uses guile and subterfuge. I need time to understand the threat they pose. My divine defenses have been breached, and the temple has been invaded. I cannot be seen to fail. Appearances are everything. They feed opinion and belief, and such matters are important to me. But enough questions. Save the temple, and you will be renowned among mortals and favored by gods.
Okay.
Thank you.
Scatter!
Oh no, the werewolf team. Don't mind if I do. Doodly doodly do. Is there another?
Thank you.
Can I sit down? Hilarious.
Since the temple is free of the Daedric incursion, we are well pleased. While you fought for my glory, I learned more about our foes. Magistrix Vox used Daedric magic to split the seams of the wards around the High Chapel. Then she opened an Oblivion Gate to fill the temple with Daedra. You need to get into the High Chapel. Vox managed to bypass the defenses, but its wards are still in place, drawing on the full power of the Tribunal. We must get you past those wards. Without the blessing of each of the three, no mortal may pass through the wards and enter the High Chapel. You have more than proven yourself to me. You have my blessing already. You would compound the sacrilege that has already been wrought upon our temple? No, that is unacceptable. If you will aid us, you will do it with our blessings, or not at all. Go to the cloisters of Vivec and Sothaseel. My companion gods are absent, but they left trials I can activate to grant their blessings. Pass the trials, and you will be blessed.
I'm gonna take a break real quick, but I will be right back. Back on. come back. Okay. Back to the crazy long quest line. Not even a main quest, like random side quest. Buff stuff.
Vivek's trial will measure your clarity of judgment. He saw our blessed people through vexing times. His wisdom reveals the secrets others keep. So shall yours be put to the test. Vivek's teachings often take the form of allegories and tales. His lessons are learned by listening and then acting. His challenge exemplifies that approach. You must listen, then act. A temple worker named Varman dueled Belrun and Telvanni, slaying him before witnesses.
I is itchy.
Varman was a loyal spy. To incite such discord was against his nature. As Vivek did, speak with Varman. Determine who truly slew the Telvanni.
Where do I have to go? Who am I talking to? Vayman?
My lord Vivek, I bear the most grievous news. Belrun and Telvanni challenged me to a duel of blood. I regret to say, I won. It was a small cut upon the arm, enough to settle the matter, but he fell dead. I was advising Tolnus and Galtzer when the others arrived, Belrun full of anger, Fenila a sneer on her lips, and Morami resigned to what came next. Belronan claimed I'd interfered in his affairs. He insisted I knew what he meant. Of course not. I told him so, but he claimed it a lie and challenged me to a first blood duel. Then everything turned to death. My blade ended his life and directly caused his turmoil. I willingly submit to your judgment, Lord Vivek. Your word is unquestioned. I am here to command. Though my blow caused Belronan's death, it was set in motion by another hand. I will aid you in discovering the source of this duel, if you will it.
The crumpled note threatens to bring Belrunan, medical Daedric relics, to the attention of the tribunal if Telvanni does. The letter is signed V but bears no other distinguishing marks. Meditate upon the duality of
Lord Vivek, Varman should be dead on the floor. Belrunan wouldn't share the note that Temple Netch sent his way, but assured me its contents were vile. One swore to the temple, quibbling over coin. You should kill him yourself, my lord.
You desire Vayman's death? Let none doubt your abundance.
A tragedy, Lord Vivek. Belrunan's death in the temple brings great shame to his house. I had thought reasoned words could dissuade him from the duel. Such temper is common to House Telvanni, but it's not my place to question their reliability.
You could doubt your artless...
Fenila lent Belronen her blade before the duel. I insisted Vaman and Belronen swap weapons. You would think she was Ash Mountain the way she feud.
Fenila's blade killed Belronen. Your words illuminate more than Athena.
Lord Vivek, I was here when Belronen issued his challenge. He would still live if not for Fenila. She stoked the Telvanni's rage, urging him not to back away from an insult to his honor. She called herself his friend. Curious way to show it.
Fenila urged the duel to happen? Curious as... Hey.
Fenila lent Belronen her blade.
A tragedy, Lord Vivek. Belronen's death in the temple brings great shame to his house. I had thought reasoned words could dissuade him from the duel. Such temper is common to House Telvanni, but it's not my place to question their reliability.
You sold Fenila poison which killed Belronen. Why?
Of course I sold her poison. As your keen eye no doubt realized, the writing on Varman's note to Belronen was my own. He sold forbidden relics, so I gave him the tools to shame himself and his house. I'm delighted he took me up on it.
Your actions led to Belronen's death.
I did nothing but provide opportunity for a heretic to destroy himself. The act of dueling anyone within the temple would undo him. It's only fitting the Fetcher did so with the tools I presented, and with such finality.
You lost control of your attempts to credit Belronen. You bear the most blame for.
You walked in our skin and wrought our judgment. You exposed the lie at the core of all truth. This may be lost on you. It does not matter.
Are you Vivek?
We are echoes of Vivek. Nothing more. All things less. We recall the wisdom of his judgment, which differed from your own. You could not know. You are not Vivek.
Who did Vivek choose?
Both. Neither. We rewarded Fenila for her cunning. Yet House Redoran suffered for poisoning a Telvanni in another's duel. We flayed Morami for her actions, yet elevated House Hlalu for its actions in exposing a heretic. Can you accept this truth?
Yes, I accept.
Through your wisdom and judgment, you have earned Vivek's favor. Receive our blessing.
So the seal values intelligence and ingenuity. He builds, he maintains, he is the master of his creations. He shall test these qualities in you.
How do I receive Sothaseal's blessing?
Sothaseal has devised a test that allows him to learn more about you each time you complete it. You are to repair one of his clockwork toys, and then break it.
I have to fix something just so I can break it?
All gears turn like the hurling disc. All artifice is ephemeral. And at times, parts are of more use than the whole. There. Divine wisdom. Does that satisfy you?
The Arbiter stands dormant. A panel slides open to reveal five empty pockets, five large pegs. The panel bears a small but legal inscription. Or legible, excuse me. A master creates the perfect, that which sparks numbers in the house built this. That which spins numbers. Master destroys the that which threatens rendered to. Not right now, sweetie. They don't have that on Minecraft anyway. Oh, I need it. How is it missing?
Sotha Seal values intelligence and ingenuity. Sotha Seal has devised a test that allows all gears turn like the hurling disc. All artifice is ephemeral, and at times, parts are of more use than.
Oh, three. So, got it. Now I can beat it up.
Reason surpassed the Arbiter's trap. In doing so, you've revealed yourself to us. You do not fully comprehend. Such is your imperfection. We are the imperfection of Sothaseel, excised from his being, yet never truly apart. We measure the indulgence of inspiration against the necessities of progression. You will never know. You are not Sothaseel.
Why did I have to destroy the Arbiter?
Perfection can never truly be attained. By testing one's constantly degrading mechanism against this unknowable goal, you reveal the imperfections of your own device. Can you accept this necessity?
I suppose.
For comprehending the necessity of imperfection,
bring me to
you have earned the blessing
West
of Sothaseel.
Match for me and my ability to run around.
I may fall, but you are too late to stop Magistrix Vox. She will destroy you all.
Wow, you only had 13 gold on him. You're a grown man. I have more gold than that.
A burst of power from the temple and ventured within, fearing the worst. But you've prevailed. What have you discovered?
The Malborn sacrificed their own troop. Foxfeet.
I will discover what powers the Judgment of Veloth possesses and why Vox has stolen it. In the meantime, you must pursue Magistrix Vox. For your heroism and service this day, I name you a Hand of Amalexia. go with my blessing upon you.
Oh, I got the hat.
As Vox fled Warnhold, she went east. With the recent troubles, the Ordinators are on high alert. One of them saw her headed that way.
Then I'll head east.
To the east of Mournhold lies Selphora, a quiet village known for its independent spirit. Vox almost certainly passed through there. Start your search in Selphora.
This quest. Thought I was jumping in the water. Oh no. Oh, come on. I have nothing.
You know, I think I'll stay right here for a while.
Turn back, traveler. There was an explosion and now Selphora is overrun. I was injured trying to get to the inn. I don't know what happened. The elders were gathered in the center of town. Then there was a flash, and suddenly, spirits were everywhere. So many people died, but they remain here as angry and vengeful spirits. I think so, but probably not far. I need to go to the inn. That's where survivors were gathering.
So where's the inn, Limp?
Elenisi? Thank the three you made it. We feared the worst. Have you brought help?
It was a close call. I'd be dead if not for this traveler's assistance.
You've chosen a bad time to visit Selphora, stranger. Spirits roam the streets and unquenchable fire consumes the town. Selphora is lost.
Don't be too hasty, Maeldris. Our new friend is powerful. I've seen what the traveler can do.
I'm strong.
I never thought I'd be so happy to get back in this inn.
Are you good here?
I think so. At least for the moment. But we're worried there are other survivors still outside. There's a temple on the hill overlooking the town. We're hoping that others have found sanctuary there.
No one's gone to find out?
We're no match for ghosts. I barely survived skirting the edge of town. None of us would make it there.
Want me to go up there?
Yes, I saw how you handle yourself. I know you can make it.
How do I get there?
It's on the other side of the bridge. There's a staircase to the south of here, but I can't tell you if the path is safe or not.
Ooh. Looks like...
How can I work in these conditions? I'm a healer, not a miracle worker.
Sorry to interrupt your ghostly sweeping session.
You saved the woman. You have my thanks.
You're the only spirit trying not to kill me.
That is true. My suffering follows a different path. I'm cursed to only observe.
Who cursed you?
My thoughts, my memories, they're a jumble. I think there may be a way to save the town. It's so hard to remember.
I need to know what happened here.
It's as if a fog covers my past. I know I am cursed and little more. This is my home, and I must watch this suffering. If the veil lifts from my mind, I'll tell you what I can.
Very well, what can I...
There was a decanter somewhere in the temple below. Its water was holy. You have seen the strange fires throughout town? I remember that much. Maybe this liquid can quench those flames.
Maybe it can quench them?
I fear I don't know for certain. So many things I don't know. You'll have to test it. See if the water will work on the magic fire within the chamber of the tree. Look for a brazier of unnatural flame.
Chamber of the tree?
When St. Veloth came to Resdane, what Morrowind is now, he planted the seeds of his homeland. Only the Tree of Somerset survived. This temple was built around it. Strange. Why do I remember this clearly when all else is fog?
I'll find this.
Be wary, stranger. My heart tells me spirits aren't the only things left in the wake of Selphora's destruction. You saved the woman. You have my thanks.
Thank you.
Your girl found a decanter. Put it out.
Sephora is dead. You will not save her.
Gained the decanter. There was an echo here, but now it is silent. The defilement begins to lift from Sephora.
What's happening, spirit? What did I fight down? I don't know.
The fog begins to clear, but so many memories rush in. What you fought was an echo of Magistrix Vox. She left it here to bind the spirits to this place.
Oh, it was that bitch.
Part of her punishment of Sephora.
What's she up to?
There's something you must see. Praise to the three, Magistrix Vox. To what do we owe the honor of your visit?
Behold, I bear the hammer of Veloth, priest. I have come to rally my people against the taint of the three.
What are you saying, Vox? Have you gone mad?
Mad? You want to see mad? Let me show you true madness.
I have shown you everything I can remember.
Did Vox kill you?
I remember my death, but that is the past now. You have more pressing matters to deal with than to listen to a ghost's stories. You have the decanter now.
Well, give me my 211 gold.
There are two people still trapped in the town, a young man and a woman, but the magic of fire closes in on them.
I can use the decanter to extinguish aim.
Yes, that should work. Find the houses in which they are trapped and save them.
I'll do what I can.
Who are you? How did you get past the flames?
That isn't important now. To get to the end.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Thank you.
someone would come. I never gave up hope.
Happy to help. You should go to the inn.
It's close by. Now that the fire's out, I should be able to make it.
Hurry up and get out, sick. Okay, I'm gonna put out this last spire and then I'm gonna break. Oh, there's no fire. Oh, it's just the end. Okay. That works for me.
My mother and brother are safe, and I have you to thank. Praise the three they survived.
I had some help. A forlorn spirit told them.
So not every spirit in Selphora is filled with hate? Then I am thankful to it that my mother and brother are still alive.
Is there anyone else?
My father, Tidinar Thalin. No one has seen him since the catastrophe struck. Was he at the temple?
I didn't see.
Maybe he went to the town hall. It's usually locked. Here, take this key. Please, he might be hiding there. He might be injured.
I'll go and see if he's there.
Eden's gone, I'm afraid. I'm all that remains of his too short life.
You're that guy?
I am. I was. What's the proper way to say that when you're dead? Don't be. You saved my family. And you can do something more. You can save Selphora with the decanter. It can do much more than put out magical fires. It's a vessel for spiritual energy. Ah, so much to explain. Understand this. The echo of Vox that you fought earlier isn't gone. It's my jailer and tormentor. I'm chained to it, but it's also chained to me. Go to the crater in the middle of town. When you get there, I'll summon Vox's echo. Defeat the echo again, but this time, draw it into the decanter.
Alright guys, I'm actually gonna sign off.